Hello, everyone. I'm Andrew Reiner. This is Game Informer's Replay. On this episode, Jeff Cork and I are going to roll our eyes as two huge Mega Man nerds just nerded up here. This is one of their favorites. This is Mega Man X2. The people I'm talking about are Kyle Hilliard.
Hey, I love X2.
And Tim Turi.
Which Sonic is this?
This is Mega Man
which
X.
Which Sonic
Tim.
Is this one?
This is Mega Man X.
Oh, man, Robotnik's done really well for himself. Did you see all those robots?
Yeah, robots.
Excuse me? Gosh.
Yeah, did you see all those? Dr.
Say Robotnik. That again.
Robots? Was Dr. Nope. Dr. Robotnik? Look at that.
Oh, good. I have some help.
You mean Dr. Eggman.
Did Robotnik make that robot, too?
I think so. This could be far past, you know, in the future of Sonic the Hedgehog.
This is 6 months after, I think the story said, right?
6 months after Sonic the Hedgehog.
Not much has changed.
Tim, you read the crossover, right?
I read some of it.
From Archie Comics?
I read the first issue.
But that was Mega Man, not Mega Man X.
How did they cross over? What is the setup for that?
Oh, just like interdimensional portals or something?
That'll do it.
That's what happened. That's cute, though. You can see Wily and Robotnik riding on a tandem bicycle.
Wow.
But one of the things, speaking of Dr. Light, or doctors in general.
Oh, my gosh.
My pediatrician was Dr. Light growing up. I'm a robot boy. just wanted
say,
to
say that again.
I'm a robot boy.
Is that the punchline? I don't know where that was going.
No, I want to say, Kyle, I know you and I have talked about Mega Man X quite a bit.
Extensively.
Nothing else, in fact. You like... From the impression of you, Kyle, is that you're sort of like a middling Mega Man fan.
A middle Mega Man fan.
But Mega Man X is huge for you.
Yeah, I love Mega Man X.
The classic series, it sounds like you could take or leave.
Yes.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Mega Man X is way faster. You can jump on walls.
They are better games. Like, Mega Man X, if you made an argument that Mega Man X is the best, like, you know, side-scrolling Mega Man game in the series...
Oh, I missed.
There's going to be people that are going to say, like, well, no, two, because of this and that. But it's almost like the Metroid versus Super Metroid argument. You know what I mean?
You did raise a pretty good argument there, though, Tim, in your hypothetical.
Okay, thanks.
This and that.
You really worked that guy, man.
Yeah.
Nice work.
I'm kind of nervous because I feel like I have a lot to prove playing a Mega Man X game.
You just proved it right there.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's talk about what makes the X series better, though. Dashing wall jumping.
You've got dash.
Yeah.
You've got the wall jump.
And you got
Sergei's and violin.
You've got animal-themed bosses.
You've got Boomer Kerwanger.
Oh, I wish I could remember some of the other crazy names.
Chill Penguin, Flame Mammoth.
Armadillo. There's one that's like Rongo Bongo, though, in Mega Man X1, one of Sigma's bosses.
You've got a cool password screen.
Good music. Awesome music.
Yeah, the music is really just sort of like kind of butt rocky, kind of let's go for it, you know? Robot rock.
I actually played through X2 in the last couple months when it came out on the Wii U Virtual Console. I played through it again.
Wire Sponge.
Yeah, it shows, man. It shows that you played this recently, actually. I do want to point out that they made a mistake by not having the classic boss select music
got a heart?
Play when you chose a guy. You know, like the da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I like that song.
Yeah.
I guess if you destroy those, it changes the weather, but...
Yeah. Another cool thing about the Mega Man X series, specifically one stands out, but like, hey, go kill Chill Penguin, and then Flame Mammoth's like lava stage is frozen over. You know, doing little things like that.
Oh, gosh.
Kyle.
Oh, sorry.
Or God, if you get the flamethrower, you can go and set, like, leaves on fire in a forest stage, and it'll reveal, you know, health upgrades and stuff.
Yeah.
That's the other thing that made the X series so cool.
Yes.
You could collect hearts, and it would extend his life gauge.
Yeah.
Or you get the E-tanks, which are called sub-tanks in this game.
I think they were just sub-tanks in the first one, then they became E-tanks.
Yeah.
I don't have any yet to look
but
at.
Basically, you could grind enemies to get health so that during a boss fight, you could call on one of these sub-E-tanks.
And in X2, there's actually a rune that you can find in Bubble Crab stage that lets you fill up the tanks immediately.
Oh, really?
Very cool, yeah.
Is it just like part of...
You just need the silk weapon that sucks everything up, and you get a bunch of health all at once.
Speak of the devil. There's that life over there, Kyle. Why didn't you get that life?
Because I don't need a life to know how to rock.
Wow.
But didn't you just die?
Hockey.
I don't know if I agree with that at all.
Oh, that's a boss place.
Oh, she's suddenly not so cocky. Oh, I don't need any lives. When faced with the opportunity to fight a boss, Kyle flees.
The door did not open. The door didn't open.
Oh, okay.
You have to defeat a couple bosses first before those three guys come after you.
I thought I sensed trepidation in your voice.
No.
You guys, it's way easier to talk when you aren't playing a video game.
Do you like it, Tim?
Yeah, because Kyle's good.
Well, don't get used to it.
Damn it.
Yeah, Tim let me... Well, I would like to... I think Tim let me play the game because it really is his turn to play a good game. But I was like, no, I want to play Mega Man X.
You guys saw some slowdown there. This isn't 1080p, 60 frames per second.
Oh my gosh, turn it off.
It's a feature, not a bug.
You guys are really dangling the Robo Carrot in front of me with what good games are like.
Where does this rank, Tim, out of the 84 Mega Man games on your list?
My gosh. You know what? Honestly, I have such strong love for X. And then I played X2 and X3, and those kind of blended together for me. But I remember they felt like they were much harder, to a point where like I felt like challenge was usurping like just clever game design. And maybe that's because I hadn't memorized all the Robot Master orders and stuff like that.
So which one takes the X prize?
X prize. Is that like the X best? Games?
Yes.
The first one.
The first one's the best.
Yeah. Okay.
Because it may be
I thought you said the vest.
Oh.
That was weird.
If I would have localized this, I would have turned it into a pickle.
Really?
But then he wouldn't be an animal theme.
The wire pickle.
He's a wire sponge.
Yeah, he's a sponge.
It's more of a pickle.
But aren't sponges aquatic animals?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why he's like
it looks more like a cucumber, right?
A sea cucumber.
Yeah, exactly.
Put down your swingy thingy.
He looks like a Dragon Ball Z enemy that got like like strung up with the Total Recall universe.
He has
or something.
A lot of problems. I think we can agree on that.
He is like
a lot of things going on there.
He's a great first boss because he looks dumb and he's easy to dodge.
Yeah, I don't have this order memorized necessarily, and so I did kind of look online, and a lot of people are saying Overdrive Ostrich first, but I like going Wire Sponge first.
Does Overdrive have the classic like run from one side of the stage to the other?
Yeah, he has that really exceptionally long stage.
Let's take a look at his character design here. Is that a breathing apparatus or are those his lips?
It's got to be a
speaker. Like a little vent thing.
A little. Oh.
Oh. Super turbo mode. That's cool.
Wow.
How are you supposed to dodge that?
It's impossible.
Also, these battles, they really took what was great about the classic series and made it more dynamic with like the mobility of jumping around a small room, being able to wall jump. And if you tap the dash button before you do a wall jump, you can like clear the entire room.
Yeah.
It's just the extra mobility makes what was already awesome boss fights. Mega Man series has some of the best boss fights and made them even better.
Tim, look to your right. Jeff Cork is judging you.
Why?
No. I'm looking with awe.
No, that's the face he always makes, Reiner.
Aw.
So I actually played Mega Man X really strange. I put my index finger on the A button.
The claw.
While I play it. Yeah, and it does hurt my thumb.
You know what? I've told you, I think, about my technique.
Yes.
Which is you remap the dash button to the left bumper, shoot to the right bumper, and then you can jump. You can jump with the face button, and it allows you just dash and jump and shoot all over the place.
Yeah. Because you want to be able to charge while you're pressing other buttons.
Yes.
What is going on here?
Hey, Reiner and Jeff.
Hey, Jeff, where does this rank for you on the top Mega Man list?
I have to say, I never played this one.
What?
So this is a wild card.
But you played X, though, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
And Kyle, we don't care about your opinion.
That's fine.
So
I'm too busy.
We're just not going to ask it.
Kyle, is this number two for you?
No, at three, it probably goes X1, X3, maybe four, then two.
One, three, four.
No, I haven't played four all the way through, and I heard it's like one of the best. Adam Biesener, who used to work at Game Informer, was just a huge, is that your impression of Adam?
That's my impression. I wasn't buying him. I love Adam.
But yeah, he's a huge, huge fan of X4. But
yeah, it's tough. It has one of the hardest Sigmas.
What does that mean?
Excuse me?
Yeah. Sigma replaced Wily. He was the boss of this series.
But
speaking of that, that was so cool about Dr. Light. He's still in the game. I mean, he's long dead by the time the series takes place, but you go to these capsules that have like his programmed AI in it, and he talks to you and gives you new abilities.
Yeah,
new items.
I don't know how he knew like what to expect. Like he just knew I would need like be able to dash in the air.
Get it.
That was the other cool thing.
Kyle, it's like Easter up there. Get it.
I'll die.
Not worth it.
I need some flame boots.
But I want to point out that was the other thing that was cool about it. You get new helmet, new boots and stuff, and it would make you stronger. You could take more hits, and you know, your helmet might be able to break apart. Things that would fall on your head would break, and they wouldn't take damage.
I have a serious question.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think we need to bring back Battle Network?
No.
There's already so many that probably even diehard fans didn't play.
I think Rush Dog should have his own game.
You
don't like our ideas, Kyle. And
what would he do? I'm just trying to think of what I'd want to do as Rush.
I was trying to do a trick where I go to the other side of the rocket, but I messed it all up. Apologies.
James Bond could do that. That's not so special.
Yeah.
Moonraker. More like Moonbreaker.
I'm actually, I don't know if I can beat Overdrive Ostrich.
Look at that background. Really nicely colored.
You can beat him. I have faith in you.
Thanks, Jeff Cork.
Don't blow it. You can do it. Overdrive the special power you got.
Peace.
Here he comes. He's not that fast. Oh, he even does the Roadrunner stuff.
What sound does an ostrich make?
Let's listen. I think that's the noise it makes.
Oh, is it Tauntaun? No, Tauntauns go...
Is he hopping yet? Is there a Tauntaun in here?
That's from Banjo-Kazooie.
No, Tauntauns may be from Banjo-Kazooie. They're just missing the googly eyes.
This stage is real... Oh, gosh.
Oh!
Do I have any sub-tank stuff? Oh, I do. I'll go and use it.
More like
or I could just unpause.
More like you have like a different weapon? Use the S-chain.
No, it doesn't do anything for Overdrive.
Okay, Mr. Expert.
You got to use that on... You have to use that on Wheel Gamer,
there he is,
Jeff
Kyle.
Cork.
Mega Man Expert.
Two.
Get out of there!
There we go.
Go, 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 go.
I love that sound.
I think that's the noise the ostrich makes.
Oh, what's that move? Oh, he's got like Quick Man boomerangs floating around.
I wonder if that's a reference.
Could be quick, because Quick Man's super fast.
Oh, come on.
You have some sweet reflexes, man.
I'm impressed.
At some point during this boss fight, Jeff Cork's going to attempt to slap you.
Let's see. That was on purpose.
Nice.
That was on purpose.
I didn't know we were playing slop here.
Keep messing up my... Yeah, that's not so great.
Sorry to disappoint you.
We'll edit it. We'll make it look cool.
Oh, cool. Thanks, guys.
What do you guys?
Don't worry, you didn't get hit there either.
What do you think of the mode 7 when he comes in from the background?
It's pretty cool.
Nice.
This has some 3D effects in it.
It looks like it starts as mode 7.
Cal, don't forget about your E-tank.
But goes frame to frame. Toward the when it gets closer to the screen, like right there. That's not mode 7 still, is it?
I thought it was. So that has something to do with it. Maybe it's just a sprite getting larger.
Isn't that basically it?
I thought so. I don't know what the difference would be then.
Okay, watch. That's what's up, but not anymore.
But not anymore. Once he goes off the screen.
Yeah.
You're good, man. Get it!
Boom!
Yeah. Those are good explosions, too.
Yeah.
All blue fire.
I love just watching him explode. You just kind of sit there. You're not worried about it. You're just right next to it.
That's like a UN squadron leftover explosion.
Yeah. Oh, man. Where should we go next?
They're up there with like the sound that it makes when you kill a Final Fantasy boss in 7 or whatever. They're just the... You know that sound?
Mm.
It's pretty great.
Spit?
Yeah, sorry about the microphone.
I guess I should go get a capsule. I don't remember where the capsules are.
Kyle, you're really good at this game.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
I've never seen anyone.
We can't air this on replay.
We can't sully our name.
Can we get Dan Tech down here? Put him on the sticks?
Ooh.
Oh,
he doesn't
gosh.
Need to know about that.
I like all these insults being thrown around.
There's Dr. Kane. Because he has Kane. Is this
Dr. Kane? Strange.
Oh.
Dr. Strange. Dr. Kane, what happened?
Well, I guess
we'll never know.
Nope. It's not that important.
What's happening? Explain the story to us.
So, Sigma's crew of three.
Those three mysterious dudes.
X. And they've decided to come after me. They were ignoring me beforehand because they didn't think I was a threat.
Then you handily destroyed that giant robot.
Yeah, right? And they have Zero, apparently, who died in the first game.
Mm.
And
did you cry?
I was very upset, yeah.
What was that?
Four, five, eight, one, something.
And you can... So if you beat them, you get Zero's parts, but you can also not fight them, and then you have to fight a Zero boss.
It's actually Zero's pants.
Where do you want to...
The reindeer. The reindeer.
Flame Stag, I think?
Yep. Yeah. Jeff, I like that joke.
That's all right.
I might be able to beat Flame Stag with just
Kyle,
Buster.
In which of these first three Mega Man X games do you get Zero's Buster? Is that the first one? It's got like the double helix thing.
So in X3, you can actually like play as Zero intermittently.
I know, but doesn't he have the sword by then? Or is that just in 4?
Unless I'm just like remembering incorrectly, I don't think you really get any... I mean, I guess you could count... I want to get on this guy. Let's go up. You could count X1 because he gives you your weapon after if you don't get the weapon capsule at the end of it.
Yeah, I think you get it from him as he's dying, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's what I'm thinking of.
Is that a beetle or an elephant?
The stag beetle. I think they're a big deal in Japan because they're always in Japanese video games.
And dung beetles are also.
Of course, that's just like a little useless shortcut.
How do you love it just like when you get shut down by like a piddly little enemy like that?
Yeah, I know.
Not my
It's like Mets in Mega Man, like the early Mega Man games.
And if you're the guy that's placing those, that's got to be so satisfying because you just know someone's going to trip up on them.
Oh.
That's probably some instant death coming after you. Whoop. This is where being good at wall climbing has...
Oh!
Go, go, go! Oh!
run, Kyle!
I really wanted that heart piece.
Yeah, well, do you have a weapon that could break that barrier?
I can get it quickly enough.
Kyle was just massaging his hand like, like something went wrong. Do we got to put you on the DL? Do we got to call in Tim?
No, I'll be okay. I can do it.
This isn't the custom controller that you typically use.
I really would. Tim's suggestion for a controller is actually really good, but I'm just so used to playing this way now that it would really be really hard to adjust it.
I mean, you can, though. I switched from inverted to regular with Call of Duty. I did it in like one play session with Cork, actually. Cork just berated me enough when you're playing Call of Duty that I switched over.
There we go.
You got it, Kyle. Come on. Come on, kid. Come on, kid. Get out of there. You can do it, Kyle. You know? Reminds me of like when I was learning how to play guitar and I was doing all downstrokes and playing like to speed with some songs. I'm like, I should probably play with alternating picking style. Yeah. And then I switched and I was for the better. Mm-hmm. You can do it.
Let's go in here. I think there's
we don't need to talk about it now.
So we can fight the boss here.
Okay.
Who is tough and I don't think I can beat him.
Cool. Well, then don't do it. No. Why would you do that?
All right. Let's go fight Flamestag.
Wait. Which boss is in there?
It's one of the three guys, like the bonus dudes.
You think you just need more hearts and
yeah,
armor?
They're tough.
So you got to revisit this level later then?
Well, so there is a kind of out-of-the-way entrance to fight those guys in every level. And they jump around as you... Like, they'll be in new levels. They actually might not even be here. I didn't check before we started.
That's a clever enemy, I just wanted to point out. Like, that's just gas, and you can't let the flame enemy get near it, otherwise it'll ignite it.
Oh, that's super cool.
Yeah, I like that kind of stuff. Mega Man was always great about that. I think it was one of the earlier NES games where there's enemies that are on fire, and it's a dark area, and if you kill them, you're safe from them, but now you have to platform through the dark. So you have to remember what you saw before you killed them. There's always clever little things going on like that.
I think I played the first three of these games. I just don't remember them.
Yeah, they blend together really, really seamlessly.
Yeah, two and three definitely blend, even for me.
You weirdo, you didn't jump.
Oh, I totally wasted the opportunity.
He slid.
That's pretty cool.
Not a jump. That's pretty much the opposite.
Yeah. And wait for it.
Oh, I've already messed up.
So he's a deer.
Oh, jeez.
I think I remember this guy being hard.
Does he want to be a deer? Is he a different animal?
He's
but
a
he
camel.
Flame
with fire
antlers.
Horns.
Yeah.
His name's Kamal.
Kamal.
When he dashes, he jumps.
Ooh,
the end of
that
it.
That sucks.
He has a name.
Do you have two full E tanks?
I do have some E tank stuff. So. Not
fair.
Actually, yeah. Keep an eye on my health. Let me know if I.
Are you trying to just not use their weaknesses out of?
I don't have it yet. It's bubble crab. You actually beat this guy with bubbles.
Excuse me?
Well, what made you what made you go for a robot master that you didn't have the weakness for?
Reiner demanded it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I wanted to see the reindeer, Tim.
That's fair.
Stores are putting out their Christmas stuff now, and I'm feeling the spirit.
Yep.
Reiner, I'm sorry. I would have ignored you. I have to go for the robot master order. I can't, like, undo it.
That's why I like Kyle.
Yeah.
I do what Ryan
like
tells
too.
Me.
Nice.
Look at him. Tank.
You got it anyway.
Boom. So who's the number one robot master then?
Out of all the Mega Man games
all
ever?
All of them.
No.
Duff McWhalen.
Duff McWhalen?
From Mega Man X5. I just like his name.
It's like a Guns N' Roses.
Yeah, it is.
It was, actually.
Actually, all of those robot
from
all
X5,
the Mavericks
yeah.
are named after the Guns N' Roses guys.
Mine is Woodman.
Woodman?
Yeah, I mean, his design is so cute.
Are we talking Robot Masters and Mavericks?
No, Robot Masters.
Okay.
Whatever.
There's a distinction.
There is a distinction. These are Mavericks. The animal ones are Mavericks from X.
Let's go to New Junk City.
The Reiner, robot bosses.
I think I like Woodman a lot, too. He's amazing. And then just the concept of, like, a wooden robot. Like, what are we doing here? Also, Alec-Man, just because he looks a little different than the rest of
Big
them.
Big fan of Cut-Man.
But you could also say Woodman's the worst.
That's right.
Yeah,
it's a wooden robot.
This will always creep me out when I was little because there were like these dead hanging robots that would come to life.
It's like a robot graveyard.
Yeah.
Oof! And he just throws up on you.
Ah, kill me!
I'm like skipping all the capsules. I don't quite remember where they are. I know there's one here, but I think actually I need the Wheel Gator weapon to open an opening right
if
here.
If it makes you feel better, you're not playing for keeps because
that's
this
true.
Is an episode of Replay.
How long would it take you to finish this game, Kyle?
Probably like 2.5 hours.
Wow.
3 hours. Because,
I mean, it's just like any Mega Man game where, like, it takes you about twice as long to work through Wily's stuff as anything else to.
Because you hit Sigma,
because they're so difficult, and there's always more levels than you remember.
And you have the world record for speedrunning this game too, Kyle, right?
Let's go with that.
2.5
Don't
hours.
Look that up. I do actually have delusions of grandeur to try to speedrun Mega Man X. Because I've gotten it down to like an hour.
What's the record?
I think the record's like 20 or 30 minutes or something.
Okay, that's gonna be a problem.
Oh, I hate this. This guy's actually tough.
It's a facehugger robot that just possessed that junk robot. That's pretty cool.
He wasn't always junk.
All right, now I gotta fight the.
And then he goes into another one.
Yeah.
Is that his weakness?
That's a little trick there.
Fire, huh?
Yep. That's actually the weakness for this boss of this level. I'm doing something correctly for you, Tim.
Nice. Why start now?
Replay fans got to be so confused by how well you're playing.
They're like, surely this is a bot.
Hey, they watched me play Resident Evil 1. Come on. Give me some dew. Mountain Dew.
At the end of this footage, you're going to see the Let's Play guy who we stole this video from saying, hey, be sure to subscribe. And hit say something in the comments. Be
like, God's sake, please don't forget to subscribe. I'm glad YouTube videos remind me to do that because I always forget.
Oh, God, what am I going to do next?
Hey, why isn't Mega Man affected by that magnet?
He is. I guess he's not.
He's
really
ceramic.
He's like a Glock.
Yeah, exactly.
Those guys are made
Glock
of
Man.
Enemies from Mega Man X1.
They remind me of Transformers after the movie. There was a motorcycle guy. Sorry, did I interrupt you, Tim?
No. I said Glock Man before, and I felt like it was pretty good, and then no one said anything, and then I kind of got taken out of it for a second. And
I didn't really get it.
I had to reevaluate. Well, Rockman.
Okay.
But, you know.
It's funnier now that you've explained it.
Right, yeah, if you want, you're always talking about the Transformers movies. I know how much you love them.
There's a guy named Wreck-Gar, right? You remember him?
Is he from Rugrats? Reptar?
Never mind.
Are you talking about the 80s Transformers movie?
Yeah. Oh, okay. And then, no, God, I wouldn't talk about the Michael Bay movies.
Right, okay. I didn't think so.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. After everything fell apart and there was Rodimus Prime and all that, there was a guy named Wreck-Gar. He was
Rodimus
like a motorcycle.
Rodimus Prime?
Didn't they go to like a trash planet too?
They tried to replace
that's where he was.
With the Weird Al soundtrack?
Well, there's Dare to Be Stupid's up. In the soundtrack, yeah.
I think it's in the movie, though, too, when they go to the planet.
In the soundtrack to the movie.
Okay. All right, let's see if I can do this one.
You can do it.
I can use the
Who is this?
I can use the flame in this one. This is Silk.
What is that?
Something?
Those robots at the bottom have nipples.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He has, like, a cocoon thing.
Yeah.
Oh, that he didn't like that at all.
No, he's not a fan.
Is this? He changes, right?
He's
metamorphosizing, right? Is that the word?
That cinematic SNES effect that a lot of the games took advantage of. Some called it slowdown.
Yeah, it's the John Woo effect.
Pre-bullet time.
Boom.
It did feel cinematic, didn't it?
At the time, yeah. I didn't think it was like the game slowing down. I was did you guys slowing down to make it cooler.
Did you guys feel that helped you?
Oh, yeah.
In certain games?
Like Gradius? Remember that came out on
and
SNES?
Didn't it make it feel awesome, too? Like, the game's just going so hard that it's like slowing down.
I'm just too good.
It's like, this game is really
can't keep
the
up with me. This is where it gets kind of tough, actually. I might have to use an E-Tank.
Shedding his...
Mothra!
Oh, it's beautiful.
You should use an E-Tank. You earned those.
Well, I don't need to use one yet.
What are those spores, though? If they're robots, what are those spores?
Those are sparks.
Sparks?
Right?
Huh? That's some kind of rust particle.
Moths have spores, right? Or what do they sprinkle on you?
What?
What are you talking about?
I don't know. Every time I see a moth, they're always dropping stuff like that. Like Resident Evil... Mega Man X2.
Oh, yeah. Dark Souls, they even drop like poison on you.
So what
I guess they fly onto plants and stuff, right?
But is that moss?
It's supposed to be like pollen or something?
I don't know. It's a recurring trope in games.
I'm really confused.
You haven't seen that?
Let's see.
I guess so. Yeah, Tim's right. They do spray some kind of fluid or
common thing. I don't
dust.
Know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I think video games kind of get a lot of stuff going on.
Well, when did moss become like even remotely associated with like poison or noxious?
I don't know. They're not as cool as butterflies, so we like make them enemies.
They're obsessed with lamps.
They're so gross.
They really are gross. I always the disappointment when you're like, oh, is that a butterfly? And then it's some nasty moth with their big dumb bodies that are always too heavy, and you pick them up and you ugh.
Yep.
Yuck.
Little triceratops. Robo.
Things guys are cool. I always thought of them as like football players because it looks like they're wearing helmets.
Yeah, they're just dinosaurs.
Right, let's see if. Oh, I should be able to do this. Let's. Oh no.
Nah, you don't got that. Sorry. You probably got it.
That's an
I think I might actually need the gun power up to use the flame stag's power up because he does like a midair dash thing. I think I'm just gonna skip it because I don't think I am capable of doing it right now. Oh, almost landing some spikes.
That screen is shaking a lot.
We're on a ship in the air, flying
over
a city.
They don't have stabilizers? I mean, Gene Roddenberry thought that up in what, the 60s?
There was already a train-themed Robot Master, though. Was it Charge Man? Well, I say he's like from 5 or 6, but there's a train. You fight through a train level, and then you fight a robot train at the end of it. That's a smaller train that fits inside the larger train.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Oh, where do I go? This reminds me of Bayonetta. You ride in some big like melee robot things like that.
Bayonetta 1 or 2?
2. They may have been in 1 too, but 1, Tambien.
So I need the capsule to dash in the air, and then I need to charge up Flamestag's weapon to do another dash, so I can't get there right now.
Cool.
Sorry.
Thanks for explaining your incompetence.
You're welcome.
Oh man, I just get to troll people when I'm not playing. This is cool.
Now you understand Dan a little better?
Is that, yeah.
Why he was the way he was?
I don't have to prove my abilities at all. Didn't hurt that he beat us a lot in multiplayer things when it did come down to it.
You mean the games that he played religiously and wanted to do for replay?
Well, hey, we always ended up, you know, honoring his request. If we could do it all over again.
I think if you keep going up there, you get to those secret bosses.
Oh, nice.
So are we going to try to beat all 8 masters, you think?
I don't know. I mean,
wait, how long have we been going here?
If you had to guess, what would you say?
20 minutes.
25, not too far off.
Yeah, we got, I don't know, another 20 minutes here.
See if I can do it.
Kyle's looking good. He might beat the game.
No.
Yeah, that Sigma's fortress is going to... Are they? But they're pretending Sigma's dead, right?
Yeah, Sigma's not part of this yet.
I love all the false...
Whoa,
enemies.
That's an eye.
Yeah, this is cool. I think, okay, so this guy's kind of tough.
You said that last time.
I know, I keep saying it, but I do have E-Tank, so it shouldn't be...
You're fighting in, like, oil or something?
Yeah.
Blood.
This guy, you got to use the, let's see.
This reminds me of that scene from Adaptation.
Which scene is that?
I can't say.
Oh.
But I wanted to make the weirdest reference to a alligator in a movie.
Oh, okay. I see what you're doing.
Hey, Cork, do you know what the difference between an alligator and a crocodile is?
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
Salt water and fresh water.
Is it?
They have, like, the way their jaws work.
Oh, for real?
Like, alligator and crocodile. I can't remember. Crocodile, I think.
Well, alligators
can close
are Florida.
Its mouth entirely.
Okay.
Do you used to work at a zoo?
Out. No, I've eaten a lot of
Could
both.
Fool me, though.
Oh, because I look like a monkey. That's what you mean. I see.
Have you eaten a lot of crocodile and alligator?
No.
Oh.
I wish.
This guy seems pretty,
pretty
regimented.
Tough.
It's tough to dodge that.
Getting up close.
The one that, like, on the when he throws the spike ball thing up. This is actually kind of hard to dodge because sometimes he'll like jump up and grab you in his teeth and shake you around.
Oh, that's like his big one.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. This is the guy where you can use his weapon to start, like, opening walls and levels and stuff and find capsules.
So we got, what's his name? What gator?
Wheel Gator.
We got Wheel Gator. We have Duff McWhalen. Was there a shark maverick as well? There had to have been.
Man.
There better be.
We had, Launch Octopus?
Yeah, he's cool. Don't try to spin around. Stab me. Please.
I mean, you got to think shark is one of the first things you think of, right?
I don't think there's a shark, actually.
I mean,
that seems ridiculous now in retrospect.
I have incomplete X series knowledge, so I mean, I could be completely talking out of turn here.
It always annoys
that surprises me, Tim, that you said you didn't beat those games.
I've beaten X 1, 2, 3. I've beaten Mega Man 0, 1, 2, and 3. I've played a lot of Mega Man. I think it's easy to forget how much of the series there is.
Yeah, there's a lot.
I would like to see someone hack the game to remove that flowing texture just to see what's going on underneath it. Like right now, what's he doing? Is he just like walking slowly?
I think that's been done because it's like when you play on emulators and stuff, you can remove layers, and that's just a layer.
Oh, yeah. Or
so what is he doing then, Kyle?
I bet he's eating crackers.
Eating crackers?
Yeah, I bet he disappears.
Yeah?
I bet he completely disappears when he's underwater.
I would like to find out.
Well, we're not going to find out today, Jeff Cork. Sorry to disappoint you.
Don't forget about your E-Tank, dude. Oh, you don't need it.
Almost did, though. Why'd so now we can take on Bubble Crab, and I can show you that secret room.
Nice. I want to see the secret room.
Let's do it.
Is it pretty cool?
It's going to be really disappointing.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Tim will like it, though, right?
Go check out that.
Oh, wait. You know what? I don't have the gun capsule, so I can't even take advantage of the secret room.
How do you get the gun capsule?
I think it's in the robot graveyard.
Of course.
We'll go back there.
So at the end there, is it his eye that winks when he throws his fist up, or is it a gem on his helmet?
Oh.
I think something is shining.
Is probably the gem?
Probably.
Like you got a battery charge or something?
Yeah.
We're going to come back here for a visit.
Or it's like a samurai unsheathing his blade.
Yeah.
What's that? What is that called again? Do you guys know what the name of that is? Like,
what?
There's a name for that. Where you just like you see the crazy flare off of a reflection off of
the
a... Yeah, and then that sound like off of a... Usually off of swords and stuff in anime.
There we go.
Cool.
Oh.
Interesting.
Cool. All right.
And this is...
There
he is. Dr. Light.
Oh!
Mega Man X, enter the capsule.
Can you do that terrible
Mr. Hansen,
Mega Man 8?
I'm obviously trying to do that.
Oh, we'll modify your body armor.
You got to stumble and then not do a second take.
With it, you could absorb damage and transfer it into explosive weapon energy. That's a good question.
See ya.
When we find those enemy emissions, we'll find Dr. Wowie.
Oh, that's the...
I love you asking me if I should try to do that.
I know.
As I'm trying to just terribly
can
do
you
it.
Do it worse?
Yeah. Can you please do anything else?
So you just leave the level now?
Yeah, we can just exit.
Pretty good.
You killed Exit Man for that, right?
Oh, yeah. That was a tough one.
I don't...
Or no, it would have been like Exit... Exit...
Keep going. You're almost there.
Always.
Exit
through the gift shop?
Echidna?
I was gonna say that. No.
Okay,
exit
whatever.
Xylophone. Reiner, where's yours? What animal starts with an X?
Zebra.
Well, you're close.
X-Zebra?
Yes, that's right.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, well.
Let's get this life, just because we can.
Boom. Ooh. I love that the helmet still changes color.
Whoa.
Get out of here, fish.
Like torpedo fish.
Cool.
I think there's a trick to actually taking out this really quickly, but I don't remember what it is.
I remember this.
Is the trick just to stay behind it?
No, there's a certain weapon that you can use that's like, we'll just take him out super fast. I don't remember what it is. I don't think I have it yet.
Sounds great.
Could you have been running ahead of it right now?
I don't think so. Let me try that. Cool. Oh, so my new thing that I got is, you hear that little... suction noise when I get hit. That's it's charging up this thing that I can do like an ultimate explosion.
Every time you get hit.
Yeah, it's like charging up. Let's see. See, there it is right there. It's about halfway full.
Huh.
All right, so this is a secret room.
Oh.
And what I don't have the power up, but what you can do is you can charge up on this weapon and it'll pull in a bunch of health all at once, which is super handy.
It's a little secret.
Yeah.
That is nifty. Man, you'd really have to like... Go. You have to first find that room and then think to do that.
Yeah,
like,
and this was... My brother figured it out. This was, like, you know, before... I don't think we even had a strategy guide for this game.
Well, his friend's dad worked at Nintendo, right?
That's right.
You guys ever fall for the friend's dad that works at Nintendo thing?
I would have.
Yeah. No one ever pulled it on you.
No. I did have friends that say they had games early and all that stuff.
Yeah.
But they ended up not having them.
Probably just got a magazine.
That's another...
We all know it's impossible to get a game before.
Right, obviously.
It's another secret room where if you use that weapon, it gives you a bunch of weapon charge-ups.
Oh, so you come to this level to restore, basically.
Yes.
Oh!
So there's a secret room.
Yeah.
It's embarrassing.
We can edit that out.
Oh, good.
Wade, if you could...
I'm all out of edits.
If you could cut... No, I was going to say, if you could just cut that and loop it for a while.
I used up my edit budget, so... Sorry.
Shoot.
Premium weird editing software. free to edit.
Edit Echidna. There it is.
Oh, this is disappointing. I thought that was something more exciting.
It's boring, Kyle. Get out of there.
Ugh, sorry to waste
boring.
Everybody's time.
Yeah.
I think that's just the boss, the bonus boss.
So what do you think of this song, Tim?
You know, pretty good. I think that the first Mega Man X is a better soundtrack, and it's hard not just to compare them all to the old Mega Man games.
Yeah. Cool. Which, those games have the best music that humans have ever composed.
Yeah,
right?
That's the crazy thing, too, about Mega Man 2's soundtrack. The composer only did that soundtrack and pretty much hasn't ever done another game soundtrack.
Because he mastered music, right? He was like, I'm done.
Prestiged. But he also has a track in Mega Man, or Mighty No. 9. Mm. So,
another visual comparison to make here. Does that background remind anyone else of
the Abyss? Yeah.
Oh, totally. You said it at the same time.
Yep. Totally know what you're talking about.
Oh, gosh.
I'm assuming that they had seen this movie, that the development team was familiar.
We probably won't get to it, but there's also a Wayne's World reference in this
game. Jump through the dark.
Wait. What? Yeah, we're not worthy.
Yeah.
It was for a Dr. White capsule?
Yeah, like if you get... So in Mega Man X, you can get capsules that like mimic Street Fighter attacks.
Yeah.
And the one in this game, Dr. Light says, like, we are not worthy before he signs off to give you the capsule.
It's a Shoryuken, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because the one's
uppercut.
You get a Hadouken in the first one. And you have to have full health and do a Hadouken motion, right?
Yeah, and that's actually, I think that's what people take advantage of a lot when it comes to speedrunning, is because you can kill bosses in like one hit using those guys.
What's your speedrunning technique, though? Do you take advantage of it?
No, it takes a while to get.
Well, also, you have to have full health.
Yeah.
And be able to pull
jump.
It off. And
I didn't jump. Oh, gosh.
And when I played this game, I hadn't played much Street Fighter, so being able to pull off that motion fluidly wasn't part of my skill set.
Because you actually have to do the attack appropriately.
What's this guy's name? Squishy Crab? What is it?
Bubble Crab.
Bubble Crab.
Oh, nice. You see, I love the logical weapons, where it's like, oh, a buzzsaw should be able to cut through a bubble pretty easily.
Yeah, I think everything you have should cut through a bubble pretty easily.
All right, let's do this. Because I don't know if we'll get to take advantage of this. So.
A child's finger will do this.
Mega Man X has one of those.
Which did, like, no damage.
That looked cool, though.
It's just, like, really effective at getting his shield down, but it doesn't do that much damage. But considering how many pips does a regular fully charged Buster Shot do?
Just one or two, and I think this does three or four.
Okay.
I mean, it's taking a good bit of damage.
Yeah, cool. That's not bad.
Yeah, let me know if I need to use a...
Nah, you're doing fine.
That did it. Oh, he just loves that.
Wow, what's
that? Yeah, that's the other reason that does it. Oh, jeez.
Quite the masochist.
So his weapon should have been used on Flamestag, but we already took care of him.
Don't say it like that.
Yeah.
So in Mega Man's fiction, do they ever go into why they only create one of each robot?
Well, they don't, because they come back for the boss rush mode. So there's at least two, I guess.
I guess.
And then
some
of them, they come back. Like, there's boss rush modes in later Mega Mans where it's just like, oh, well, here's Cutman again, or here's Gutsman again. It's very strange.
What do I have left here?
Two left.
What's Gutsman's gimmick again?
He
He's really strong,
pick up,
right?
He can pick up rocks and throw them.
Okay.
Silly. And that's what's clever about Smash Brothers, the newest one, mm-hmm. is that's Mega Man's throw. Like, when you grab someone and throw them, that's Gutsman.
Nice.
Because he has, like, the same animation. It's picking up and throwing someone. Is this, like, the mid-fortress?
Yeah, you actually come back to here when you start fighting Sigma, which is... I don't know if the other games ever really did that. So this one's, you gotta dodge these yellow circles.
Yeah, that's Pac-Man with his back to you, I think. Yeah.
Get out of here, thing. Ah, oh, set it off. Let's just get out of here.
Cool.
You need to jump on him, right? Yeah, if you don't set it off, then you can go up there, and I think there's a capsule up there, so.
Oh, Kyle.
Messed up.
It's all right. Those bricks look like they're grimacing, like they're cyclopses that are grimacing.
I forget this pattern sometimes, because it can be tricky.
Has Capcom ever collected all these, the X's?
Yes, on PlayStation 2 and GameCube.
And what is that? Is it just the Mega Man collection? Is
Mega
that
Man
part
X
of the
collection.
Anniversary or whatever?
There's the Mega Man Anniversary collection, there's the Mega Man X collection.
Gotcha. So that's probably the best way of getting these?
Yeah, if you want all of them. Yeah, I mean, I think they've been released... Some of them have been released over, you know, Virtual Console and stuff like that. And then there's, like, Mega Man X... what's the Game Boy Color one called, Kyle?
Extreme, which I played for the first time recently.
Which are, like, almost weird halfway points between the Classic Series and X Series.
Yeah. Well, they're, like, they're actually greatest hits versions of X.
Right.
Is that a polygon?
Yeah. It's crazy.
What the hell?
I know.
This is actually... I would always use that G-Crush, that super attack on this guy, because he's kind of a pain. You can only hit him in the handle.
And another question about those collections. Are they pretty true to the Super Nintendo versions?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, like, if you remember, like, I think the best system to play them on was the PlayStation, because you look at the D-pad, you look at even, you know, the face buttons and what those are obviously inspired by the SNES, given Nintendo and PlayStation's, like, old affiliation and stuff. Like, you play it on a PlayStation, you got the bumper button, You can customize all the controls.
Yeah, hate this guy.
PS2 is the way to do that, I think.
They keep the slowdown, too?
You know, I can't remember what the performance is like. I think that it's a pretty true emulation.
There we go.
Nice work, Kyle.
Yeah, these look fun. I think I want to go back and play some of these.
I really want to go back to X4. And
I think you should do that. I think we should have a show where you play it.
Oh, yeah, just like a super replay?
A completionist run for your, you know, you playing all the Mega Man games.
Oh, hell yeah, man. That'd be a blast.
We can skip seven, though.
Yes, I got excited and I said, hell yeah, man. Okay, Jeff, let me have this.
I was just imagining what hell yeah, man would be.
Hell yeah, man.
Oh, the technology is crazy.
Oh,
shoot. See, now if you get scanned by him, the mini boss gets more powerful. But I only got scanned once, so he's not going to be too strong.
That's interesting. They don't really explain that at all. What's that?
See, like, it'll bring in some data here, and then it'll do that for every time you get scanned. So if you get scanned three times, it does it like three times in a row, but since he only got scanned once.
So is it him getting new moves or something?
Yeah, like he gets stronger and like more attacks
like,
and stuff.
Here he's got the move where he stands there and shoots you, so there's that one.
He scans you three times, so he'll close his mouth.
Yeah.
Breathe through his nose.
His eyebrows will wiggle before he shoots you. You jump over both of them, huh?
Yeah.
Can you just let that...
Well, I'm too close to dash.
Can you let one of them go over your head just by standing?
Nah.
Yeah.
Dash.
Wow. No, I swear to God, you'd be fine. Oh, never mind. Don't ever listen to me.
The saboteur among us.
Saboturi.
Sorry. I'd be proud if I made that robot. That is a cool looking robot.
I also liked his repertoire. I want to know what he does with all his tricks.
If I tried to make a Mega Man, that's what he would look like.
Just like Jeff Goldblum at the end
hunched
of The Fly.
Over.
Oh!
I really want to. I do want to beat this boss.
Okay.
If we can.
One last shot.
Yeah.
And you checkpointed. You checkpointed right after that.
Yeah.
Boss,
so I don't have too much far to go. I'm gonna go a little slower here.
Take your time, Kyle.
See, these are when it gets tricky because there's like they have specific patterns that I don't quite remember.
Oh! Yeah.
Oh, nice hit. Oh.
Okay, there we go. All right.
Jeez, jump through that door.
Jump. There you go.
Nice.
He's covering
his
face.
In a mosh pit.
He's
keep those elbows up.
Yep.
All right. So, I like this boss a lot. He's fun to beat because you really can just stand in one spot.
Oh, is that the special blast thing? No, this is crab, right?
I hope
hell
he
is
no,
that thing.
It's a centipede. Hope you don't like your tail, bro.
Oh, nice. Man. Oh. His stun lock is pretty extreme. Oh, he lost his tail, yeah. Tail, yeah.
So you can just stand in the middle here. Even when he goes on the ceiling.
Is it the shrapnel gets him?
Yep.
Oh, that was close as hell.
Yeah. I love that he just, he's not, he barely, like, almost touches your head, which is fun.
Barely almost.
Barely almost, kind of, sort of. Maybe?
That's really close.
I credit actually my brother with figuring out most of these methods, and then I'm just copying him.
How many times a day do you think about him?
My brother?
Yep.
Your brother Tristan Hilliard?
76.
Yeah.
He's a nice guy. He's a photographer. A funtographer.
He's a funtographer.
He's a cartridgeographer. Oh. Sorry. Boom.
That was a good shot.
You got to jump on that.
Yeah.
Oh.
What a tease.
I totally messed that up.
What a troll.
Oh, you still got him. Or is it a she?
I think it's a he. Get out of here with your technology.
Yeah, that's what he said in the book version of this game.
We should blink some more Mega Man X.
Yeah, he's just like, can we go? Please. So tired of this.
Yawn. Wait, let's look for the shine.
Yeah, okay, I think it's on his helmet.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Shrink. Oh, yeah. I was hoping it would be a wink.
That'd be cool.
Yeah. That character. He's pretty stoic.
Good job, Kyle.
Thanks.
I think that's all the time we have for our first segment. Let's move on to roulette. When I mentioned this game upstairs in one of our writing bullpens, Jeff Cork got really excited.
Got excited.
It isn't its own series. It is actually spun off of Eternal Champions, a short-lived fighting series that was on Genesis and Sega CD. I enjoyed it a lot. Jeff, I take it you
I loved
are
it.
Familiar?
You could punch people and they would go into giant fans or get drive-bys with a lady in the ticket booth. Or it
was, I don't know if we're talking about the same game.
Eternal Champions?
Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Like, it was crazy.
Is this the same sprite guy, pretty much? Like,
what is this?
Oh, I like this move.
This reminds me of Mortal Kombat Mythology's
like
Sub-Zero, right?
Soldiers.
Am I wrong?
That totally looks like Small Soldiers.
Isn't that what you guys are thinking of, though?
Oh, Mythology's? A little bit,
Well, right. Mm-hmm. I mean, spinning mm-hmm. off a fighting game franchise mm-hmm. and taking characters mm-hmm. and trying to make them into, like, this terrible side-scrolling
thing. Oh, my gosh.
Like, Eternal Champions
was is disgusting.
Not derivative in any way, either, so.
Okay. Oh, boy. Because you're using fighting game controls, right?
Oh, gosh. So,
yeah, no.
That poor lady. Look at that turn animation.
Oh, man. Just this walk of just this trudge. Shoulders straight.
But keep just going back and forth. Like, oh, wait, you got to fight that man.
So it's three-dimensional. You can go up and down then.
Yes. Yeah, I just realized that.
Like Streets of Rage or something.
These fighting looks like the choreography from, like, the pleasure skiff in Return of the Jedi. Like, just nothing's connecting.
Look. He's got the weirdest stance. Look how high this kick is.
Kyle, let me see something real
Hold
quick.
Hold on. Look at that kick. Look how high that kick is.
Tim smells a bad game, and he's playing now.
Tim just took the controller from me.
Sorry, I just wanted to...
No, that's fine.
Oh, gross. Oh, my God. It's disgusting.
So
he, like, moves...
Do you have a jump?
No, there's no jump.
There's no jump?
Come
on. How
do you
have a fighting game with her?
Get out of here. No, we're done, lady.
Do the... I think it's this button. Yeah, what is the last button? The C button, I guess? Try that button.
Okay. What?
Yeah, that one. I like that one. What is that? Is that a block? That's a block?
I think he's wearing Zubas.
It's like no, he's doing like a Thriller dance. Like
Oh, this is great.
Yeah.
This looks what did we play last week? What was that? Time Commando? This looks looks better than Time Commando.
Ah, my people. Yes, I'm the champion. Yes.
Left. Oh, hey, there you go. You got
to
jump.
It's like doing a weak Van Halen jump. Like,
oh, my gosh. I would love to see these motion capture
You're
sessions.
Making a mockery of this game, nice. Tim. I want you to stop playing.
Yes! Yeah,
all right, Kyle.
Oh, no, I get it.
You.
Tim got it out of his system.
No, so, Jeff Cork.
Yes.
The game, the plot is based on an alternate timeline in which Shadow was not killed by Black Orchid in 1993.
It's a really interesting
I've always
territory.
Wondered, like, it's a rich area to explore.
Listen to this music, though. Hold on, let me really dig into this.
How does this compare to the Mega Man X2 soundtrack?
Look at that walk.
Geothermal something? Oh, is this something I can interact with?
Wait, you talked about fans before, right, Jeff?
Here we go.
Active. Can I punch you?
Can you punch me?
I am my high computer. Kick. Hi-ya! That's Tim Turi's line. Sorry.
Oh, just to say the word hi-ya?
Just to say
I think,
hi-ya.
I don't know hi-ya. If I was the originator.
No, you started it.
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Elevator?
I hope some bad guys do somersault kicks into the elevator as it's ascending or descending.
Oh, what did I do? Yeah, how'd you go to the background like that? That must be how you have to access those.
That'd be amazing if you could access it with the kick.
Or if you fell over when he tried to kick like that, because he looks off balance.
It looks like you touched the button there for a second.
Okay, I had something going here. Is this the button up here?
I gotta say, this guy skips leg day. It's,
Is that a code on the pipe there? Down, up, down, up, down.
No
well,
way.
No, that's...
Kyle.
That would be sweet.
Kyle, those are just one pipe goes in one direction and one goes in the other.
Oh, that makes
that
sense.
That would be the most obscure, weird thing to do right away.
God, this should not be this hard.
Go,
like,
go back
what
to
am
the
I
computer.
To do?
That the monitor, I think,
over
the
here?
Console has something to do with something.
Is it temperature reading and then.
It's at 17
controls.
Degrees.
Okay. So it's. Active. It's pretty cold then.
What?
Okay, now go.
Wait. Right.
I gotta do some dance moves.
This
in front
Genesis
of
just said something besides Sega to us.
Access restricted.
Okay, it's restricted, so you can't access that yet.
What did she say?
Mission started or something.
Oh, secondary mission started?
Yeah, so maybe go back the other way.
Okay. Yeah, maybe,
dribble.
Maybe there's more to those things.
You know, this is innovative that it goes right to left instead of left to right.
That's a good point. Well, there's the other set.
Oh!
What? Where did that come from?
Oh! you have limited ammo.
Things are starting to heat
I
up.
Can't move.
Cool. Why would you want to?
Okay.
What?
That's the start button, so that doesn't
Wait,
do anything.
What did that?
Wait, were those other characters?
Yeah, could you switch characters?
Yeah. Oh, switch to the other character if you can.
The person who can push a button.
Yeah.
What
it's
is
like
happening?
The Lost Vikings.
Tashiel. Yeah, play Shadow. Active.
Play Shadow. Oh, man.
Am I Tashiel now?
Hell yeah, you are.
Oh,
teamwork.
Oh, she moves left to right.
She looks like a computer.
She's going to activate the elevator or something.
Where is she?
She's a ninja.
Hold on.
And what does she have 40 of up there?
Something's happening.
Maybe, let's try another character. I don't know why that one's not
Try Shadow?
Shadow active. What's going on? Are we just like...
You got to get out of that airlock, man.
hit a button. Oh, man.
That's disappointing.
It's an old game. Well, maybe we could just...
Oh, do you got to go to... Sorry, you got the gun
I can't move. It won't let me move anywhere.
Well, did you hit a combo to, like, bust out that weapon?
I don't think so.
Combo.
I don't know. Double taps? A series of buttons?
I'm tempted to just use up all the ammo and hope for the best.
So, I don't know about you, Reiner, but I think it's cool we looked at this game, but maybe we could also just grab something else to play, too?
A toolet?
What?
Like a little toolet, maybe?
Let's do it.
All right, I like it.
Let's go for it.
Okay.
Jeff Cork, look what we're doing.
There we go.
Your dream's coming true.
Straight to the source.
So Kyle is going to be taking on Tim.
Yeah, that's right.
So we'll see how the original timeline plays out here.
That's Shadow. Right.
I warn you, Tim. You saw how I was pretty good at Mega Man X2?
Jedi.
I'm sure I will be the exact opposite amount of skill for this game.
So Jeff has a better memory of the fatalities, which are really hard to pull off in this game, than I do. Go ahead and describe some of them again, which I was like, I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yeah, you thought I was just rambling.
Yeah, I did. I thought you were like talking about some Dick Tracy game or something.
There's one, I think, where I might be making this one up, but this sounds like something that happens. There's like a shark eats somebody. There's another one where I think a whale eats somebody.
Sorry, who's who here?
I'm the gangster man.
The trident, I think his name was.
Right, go ahead, Jeff.
Yeah, gangster man, his level is in front of an old theater in Chicago. And he can summon like a drive-by in a car and a bunch of guys with Tommy guns will totally take out the person.
I have a grappling hook.
Or the lady at the ticket counter comes out and shoots people with a shotgun, I think. It's a helicopter on this level, like... I think this is supposed to be Vietnam or something.
Does Dick Tracy use a grappling hook or something in the movie? And that's maybe where some of that inspiration comes from.
I thought that was handcuffs, actually. But I guess you wouldn't have handcuffs for a mobster.
I'm looking up the moves here. Yeah, I don't need those. I'm not really interested.
Yeah, this is your guy, Tim, is a thief, I believe, and his name is Larson. L-A-R-C-E.
You'll never catch me alive.
I like my attack where I just kind of stretch my leg out in front of me. I'm like,
yep.
Jeff, are they called vendettas?
That sounds about right.
Or sudden death.
Oh, sudden deaths. I don't know. They all sound great.
So is this just like riding Mortal Kombat's coattails?
No!
Or was it actually like a cool fighting game? Oh, Jeff's upset.
How dare you?
Oh, jeez.
He flips a coin. It's cool.
Lady Luck's on my side.
So vendettas, it sounds like you could do anywhere.
Okay.
But it has to be like the last hit,
right? You had like
right? Stage
fatalities. That's right. You had like that were stage dependent. Then you had that were just like a regular Johnny Cage style knocking someone's head off.
I'm playing as, I was playing as Wolverine. He doesn't really look like Wolverine
anymore. Did I just bow
anymore.
To you?
You just died.
So you're like a cyborg.
I'm a cyborg monk.
Yeah.
Oh man, he's got like little boosts.
I'm just a caveman. I'm a cave plan.
I guess we're playing on the cave plan stage.
I think there's a dinosaur fatality. Can or swing vendetta club? Or sudden death.
Did you have these?
Your legs. You got a club, dude.
What are you trying to do there, buddy? I should try to use this club.
Don't worry about it.
You really should use the club.
Oh, there's a little blood there. Not a lot. Just enough.
Okay, who's Rax?
Me?
All right, I'm going to see if I can find...
I'm named after the fast food place.
All right, his vendetta is close. Forward, back, forward, back, B.
Yeah.
And you can do these at any time, or it has to be like...
You know, I'm just going to leave it at that.
All right. Let's give it a shot. Let's see. If you want to just try it here, Tim? Forward, back, forward, back.
It's a lot of pressure.
You got to swing that club
at least
once.
I think I can just do it anywhere? I can try it. Well, you're hitting me now.
I'm trying to...
Well,
just
hold
make,
on a second.
I'm just trying to make up my own combos.
Okay, cool.
Oh, sorry. Okay, I'm going to stop.
Wow, Tim. You got to be close, though.
Okay, let me give it a
You're
shot.
You're a maniac.
Yeah, you got a voice of an angel.
Thank you.
I'm trying it.
Oh, keep going.
Oh, sorry.
Come on, really going do for it.
Kyle, just stand there and take it.
Yep.
Oh.
Try it. Keep going. Drag. Don't stop. Don't stop.
Vendetta him.
Oh. Vendetta him.
You know what? I could never even pull them off in Mortal Kombat. So. But these characters are cool enough to look at.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are nice
Pick
nipples on them.
This game was rated MA-13.
For why?
My eyesight is not that great.
Let's Blade.
It's dark in here. Something.
Hey, it's the movie theater.
Yeah. That lady, she looks bored.
I look like Dr. Octopus without the tentacles.
That lady's probably cleaning her gun.
Yeah.
Oh, exactly. Look at, is that the car that shoots you?
It's one like it.
So this is Larson's stage.
Oh, yeah. his old stomping grounds.
Tim, I think you glow in the dark. Is he like Radioactive Man, Jeff? What's his name?
Well, I don't know.
They're going for a James Bond theme, though. Like
they're trying for something.
I don't know.
Certainly putting forth some effort
towards an undetermined goal.
I had a lot of fun with this game. How is it holding up, guys?
I don't know. You know what? Like, I kind of like it.
Control's okay, you know?
That's the card.
I think if this game had...
it's super slow. Don't mind me.
If this game... Well, cars back then, Kyle, didn't they like go up to like 20 miles an hour max?
I suppose you're right.
I don't know. Maybe 30. But this game has such unremarkable box art that I don't think I gravitated towards it at all. There's nothing that screamed fighting game or...
You did it.
There's also that, so... That obviously would have given me a problem as a kid. I probably would have had a nightmare.
What is the name of that movie back there?
It's Air something, and this is
Air Ranger?
Air Ranger.
Nice. Love that one.
And that, I have no idea.
I can do that. Watch out. I'll do it again.
I can't hit you while you're doing it.
I won't tell you how I did
it. Okay, wait. Tim's got a flashy thing, or who has the flashy thing?
I think I have
thing?
The flashy
Kyle?
Thing.
Okay. Yeah. What's your character's name?
Doesn't Blade.
Stop
fighting for a second, guys.
Yeah.
Doesn't that just mean he won a match?
Who knows?
No, it was there the first round.
Oh.
Where the hell's Blade on here?
Get those guys involved.
Look at the popcorn bag.
Your vendetta is close, down, down, forward, forward, X.
Oh, gosh. Okay, down, down, forward, forward, X. All I have
is ABC.
Oh!
Your sunglasses fell off.
I win!
You're just a guy.
Those are like,
glasses off?
Those are like Doc Brown Back to the Future 2 sunglasses.
I'm Midnight, by the way.
Midnight?
Okay. Pleased to meet you.
You have an open rib cage. That seems dangerous.
I think it's pretty cool.
All right.
Yikes, you're really putting the screws to me
Tim,
here. What?
You're down, forward, forward, back.
I'm getting my butt kicked, Reiner. I don't have time. I've just got to make sure he doesn't get a flawless.
He doesn't have time for your nonsense.
That's my, flawless.
I don't have an X button, which makes it difficult for me.
Oh, you got a 3 button.
Yeah, I got one of those 3 button suckers.
He fixes his hair. Jordy fixes his hair after he wins.
So it's like Back to the Future glasses, Futurama wristband, Jordy LaForge hair.
It's awesome.
Green Lantern unitard.
All right, let's do one more match here.
Oh, man. Who's
got to play somebody new. Xavier.
Have you played Trident yet?
I played as Trident the first time.
Okay.
Maybe Shadow. Might as well show her.
Yeah, she's an important character or something.
Her lack of a death inspired a spinoff game.
Best background birds ever.
Oh, this is fantastic.
She's like Elvira meets Batgirl. Hey, Shadow!
I like this.
She does the silhouette thing.
As advertised.
I like my cartwheel.
Whoa! Hey, settle down there.
Hey! Look! We gotta figure this out, man.
Oh, and her
thing is
like,
what are you doing? You're freaking me out, man. She's moving way too fast.
The pirate ship comes and blows her away with the cannon.
Is that it?
Yeah.
So it's the fatalities are based on the stages. The vendettas. Apologies.
Whatever. Yeah. There's some kind of
the sudden deaths.
God, the song's
cartwheel, cartwheel.
It's a good song.
Sounds like someone just tapping a couple keys.
She's like a gymnast.
Yes.
Hiya. What is she wearing?
It's a series of scarves.
I think
kind of looks like Dazzler a little bit.
It is a
the old 80s version.
Tattered Union Jack is what it is.
Just wrapped around her.
Yeah. Jeez. No respite. I'm like stun locked.
Boom, boom, boom.
Jeez,
nice,
Louise.
Kyle. Wow.
That stork is just
hot
watching.
Off the Evo circuit. Kyle Hilliard.
Man.
Yeah, they have a Turtle Champion
Jetta,
championship in there.
Pretty all right. What does that little bird do for fatality?
Gets out of the way. So that's Eternal Champions. We're going to show you, before we close it down here, we're going to show you some fatalities. As always, everyone, thanks for watching Replay. We'll see you on the next episode.